New York is fundamentally an immigrant and entrepreneurial city. There's an enormous pressure that boils from the bottom of the hungry people who come here. They're looking for a thing they can do. And that inevitably goes to either things that are new or the things that the elite aren't interested in doing.
It's the early 1930s. Two immigrant entrepreneurs, Harry Donnefeld and Jack Leibowitz, run a small but profitable publishing concern.
Harry was the backslapper, the glad-hander, the salesman, the con man, making people happy, telling dirty jokes, drinking, going out to girly shows. You know, that was Harry. He had mob connections, or so went the rumors at the time. It didn't help that he bragged about knowing Lucky Luciano and Frank Costello. What he didn't have is someone who really knew how to balance books and run a company, and so that's where Jack Leibowitz entered.
Harry and Jack make their fortune putting out pulp magazines.
Not just the pulps, but what we call the spicy pulps. In other words, the lascivious pictures of half-naked women on the cover and these sort of racy stories inside, or at least racy for 1935.
About as naked as the law would allow, and sometimes sort of pushing over that line. Some people did jail time for these magazines in the 30s, so they were pornography by the standards of the 30s. Harry Donnefeld almost went to jail. He had to talk one of his employees into taking the rap for him in exchange for a job for life.
The handwriting came on the wall about 37, 38. He thought, you know what, maybe spicy pulps is not where I want to be if the law is going to be breathing down my neck.
For a country in the midst of the Great Depression, newspaper comic strips are a popular and cheap amusement. Collections of these, the very first comic books, begin to appear on newsstands. And Major Malcolm Wheeler Nicholson, prolific pulp fiction writer and former cavalry officer, is inspired to put out his own.
January 11, 1935, you go to the newsstands in New York, and you find on them Fun Comics number one, the very first DC comic.
Major Malcolm Wheeler Nicholson had a sense not just that this is filler, but that new material might find its own audience.
The Major needs business partners, and Harry and Jack need less racy material to publish. And in 1937, their very first collaboration, Detective Comics, the comic that would give DC its name, hits the stands.
Why Detective Comics? Because it's an outgrowth of this whole urban culture that is fairly new to us as Americans. And the idea of urban crime was something that 50 years ago didn't even exist. And suddenly, you know, we have to worry about muggers and pickpockets and street crime. Detective Comics was clearly a response to that.
After buying out Wheeler Nicholson, Harry and Jack set out to grow their new venture,